Hi there, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm doing a home chef cook with me. These are the meals that I got in my home chef delivery. First, I'll be making the coconut curry butternut squash. Home chef is great because it gives you the really easy to follow recipes, as well as all of the ingredients pre-portioned. And it lays out the directions, pictures, and you only need a couple things that typically everyone has in their kitchen already. Bag is really nice to keep to throw your trash in whenever you're done prepping your produce. First, I'm going to start the rice and get that cooking. The directions for the rice were to bring a small pot with the rice, a cup of water, half the seasoning blend, and a pinch of salt to a boil. Then to reduce it to a simmer, cover, and cook until tender. While the rice is boiling, I prepared the other ingredients, including halving a lime and then cutting one half into wedges and juicing the other half, coarsely chopping the peanuts, and stemming and coarsely chopping the cilantro. I only used a little bit of the cilantro because I'm not a huge fan of it, but I like it for a little bit of a taste. This meal was really easy to make. I prepared it on a weeknight, which is usually busy getting my baby fed into bed. And then I've been trying to do yoga after he goes down and also keep up with keeping the kitchen clean and whatnot. Okay, my rice is boiling, so I'm going to reduce it to a simmer, cover, and cook for about 14 to 17 minutes. Drinking some Heineken Light as I cook. Always like to have a beverage on hand. Now I'm prepping the chicken and doing a little dance, keeping an eye on the rice. Not chicken, it's squash. It said to add the butternut squash to a hot pan and stir occasionally until beginning to brown, about 3 to 4 minutes. Then stir in the remaining seasoning blend and curry paste and cook until aromatic, about 2 to 3 minutes. Goes the curry paste. I was concerned about the curry paste because I actually don't know if I've ever had curry before. I was worried it was going to be a little bit too spicy, but it wasn't at all, and it was actually quite delicious. As you'll see from this video, I am an over-stir. I tend to stir way too much. Okay, then once that's ready, you stir in the coconut milk into the pan and bring to a simmer. Clearly I had to read the directions pretty closely. In the meantime, my rice was done, and so I made a little mess there. Try it. Yum. Really good. Back to stirring. Put in the coconut milk. And some more stirring. Once that comes to a simmer, cover, and cook until tender, and sauce is slightly thickened, about 11 to 13 minutes. Then once the squash is cooked, it's time to add in the peas and cook until warmed through, just a couple of minutes. From burner, stir in cilantro and 1 teaspoon of the lime juice. Taste and add remaining lime juice if desired.
was really easy. Let's see how it tastes. I like my food all mixed together, so I don't know, I'm weird. Okay, got some rice, some peas, some squash. That's really good. Wow. I didn't think I was going to like it as much as I do. That's really good. It does have a slight taste to it. So if you don't like spicy, it's not for you. I don't love a lot of spice, but this is like just right. So good. Okay. I'm going to eat this. Bye.
Hi everyone, it is now Friday, January, I don't even know what day it is, 18th? Yeah, that sounds about right. I am here with my little buddy. It is pretty much his bedtime, but he wasn't quite ready when I tried to put him down earlier, so he's just been hanging out with us for a little bit. Zach had to run out for some things. He is going to be making jerky, but he forgot a couple ingredients. Typical. I'm going to be making another home chef meal for dinner tonight, so I thought I would take you along on this one as well, and then I'm going to be making another one tomorrow night, and then I'll put it all together and let you know what I think. So I'm going to go over now what we got in this. Okay, so tonight we are making weeknight chicken fajitas. Don't those just look tasty. So it says it's supposed to take, it's gonna be easy, not spicy, and should take 30 to 40 minutes. So in it we had an onion, which my husband and I, neither of us really like onions, so I'm probably not gonna use this whole onion even though it says two. We got some sour cream for garnishing. We got some cheese. This is probably enough cheese for my husband to use for like 1.5 fajitas. So luckily we have some more because we love our cheese. We've got a yellow pepper. We've got a red pepper. We've got some taco seasoning. We've got some more cilantro. They love cilantro in these recipes. Again, I don't mind a little bit of it, but my husband does not like it. And it's just for garnishing, so I probably won't use all of that. We got some tortillas, and we got some chicken breast. So I'm gonna be making that. I think first this one is gonna go to bed though. I think this one's gonna go to bed though first because he's starting to go a little cranky. And 7 o'clock's usually his limit. So yeah, gonna go do that.
On to the next meal. Tonight we are making the chicken fajitas with peppers. This was another really delicious meal. My husband and I both really like this. Austin is still awake at this point because he just wasn't ready to go to bed. So you hear him. Well, you won't hear him because I took the sound out, but he's in the background. Playing around in the pots and pans. I took a break while filming this to go up and put him to bed. Because it's really hard to concentrate on making a meal when you have a toddler messing around behind you or underneath you. I know I cut peppers very strangely, or at least I think it's strange, but this is just the way I taught myself to do it, and the way I do it. have realized this time lapse video makes me look like my cooking skills are much better than they actually are. I also made this meal on a weeknight. Well, it was a Friday, so I wasn't as pressed for time, but still after a day of working and taking care of a baby, and it was really easy to pull together. After I prepped the vegetables, I started cooking the chicken. I only did half of the onion because neither my husband nor I really like that many onions, but I wanted to add some in for a little taste. For the chicken, you'll need 1 teaspoon of olive oil heated in a nonstick pan over medium high heat. Before cooking this, I marinated the chicken in the half of the taco seasoning in 1 teaspoon of olive oil and 1/4 teaspoon of pepper. And I'm cooking the chicken undisturbed until lightly charred, about 3 to 4 minutes. Enjoying a Hoegaarden on the side. Then I'm stirring occasionally until browned all over and chicken reaches a minimum internal temperature of 165, about 2 to 3 more minutes. And then after that, you'll transfer the chicken to a plate to keep at the side. More and more stirring. Then we add some more olive oil, bell peppers, and onion, and cook undisturbed again until lightly charred, 2 to 3 minutes. Then after the 2 to 3 minutes, stir occasionally until caramelized, about 3 to 4 minutes. This meal almost ruined this pan. I probably should have used a different one because the bottom was completely charred black and took a lot of scrubbing to come clean. Then after cooking, season with the remaining taco seasoning and a pinch of pepper. So much stirring. It's time to stir the chicken back in and cook for a few minutes until all is warmed through. And while that was warming, I prepare the tortillas by wrapping them in a damp paper towel and microwaving them for 30 seconds. Once all that's done, it's time to plate. I also garnished with cheese, sour cream, and I omitted the cilantro this night. We both, like I said before, we both really enjoyed this meal as well, and I'll be using this recipe again in the future. Even the dogs were really excited about it. Thank you for watching, and please like and subscribe below, and come back for more videos to come. Thanks, bye.